We're right in the middle of camp right now, and the biggest thing when you're a player trying to make an NHL hockey team is you want to be noticed. And there's good ways to be noticed, and there's bad ways to be noticed. And the most important thing is you might just get the slither of a chance to make an impression on the coaches to or the GM that, hey, I deserve to play in the National Hockey League. But it's not that easy because you got to play conservatively, because if you're going to play in the National Hockey League, unless you're a lottery pick, a top-end guy that has that talent level that's through the roof, you can live with some mistakes. But when you're a guy, pretty much anybody else, and that's probably 95% of the rest of the league, you've got to be able to play in the trenches, provide those intangibles so the coach knows what he's getting from you every shift. And a lot of that, I know it was a struggle for me in the National Hockey League at training camps, was that the speed of the game, yeah, it was something to adapt to, but it was still hockey. The skill level, that was something you could adapt to, it wasn't that hard to adapt to. But it was winning those puck battles to get the puck out of your zone and into their zone that is always big. Tone, we always talk about the most important things.
Oh, yeah.
There's two spots, 5 feet inside your blue line, yep. 5 feet outside your blue line, and then the offensive blue line, the same thing.
Yep.
That puck has to leave the zone, because we all know this. Once the puck leaves the zone, they've all got to leave and come back.
Yep.
You can get a line change. You can get things going. You can't get hemmed up in your zone. So we're going to show you right now some of the intangibles. It's really difficult for a young player to do because, A, you got smart, big, physical, fast defensemen that are able to jam that puck down your throat and keep it in the zone, which turns into a tired group, which usually ends up with some shots on net here. And you've got to find a way to get it out. You have to get it outside that blue line. There's many ways to do that. If you just take a step inside the blue line there, there's a bunch of different ways to do it. In a perfect world, sometimes this puck gets wrong around the boards. So the puck's coming around the boards. In a perfect world, my play on this puck is to get this puck and hit my centerman who's supporting me low. Because you can get out clean. Now I've caught you. The other defenseman's going to be in a tough spot if my far winger gets going too. It's a 2-on-1.
Right.
But that doesn't happen very often. That's option A. Option B, you can chip it off the glass, get a bounce behind that defenseman, send him on another odd man rush. Another way of doing it. But the most important thing is this puck has to be protected. It cannot get thrown back down to the corner and hemmed up. So here's some of the ways you do it. The puck comes around the wall sometimes. You can catch it, D-pinches, body up on him, slide it, like I said, to the centerman coming through. That's in a perfect world. Doesn't happen very often. It happens if you get some communication from your centerman. On a lot of times, other times, this puck's coming around. Here's your option. You can turn onto it here. D's going to come down. He's trying to hit you to keep it in. You could just lift his stick, hit him, leave the puck. Who cares about the puck right now? You're not letting him get it. And then you get in a grind here. You wait for some communication, or you can chip it out yourself. Another way, D's pinching. You can come in. Some guys you see sometimes just try to whack at it. A little golf shot, a little chip shot. See if you can catch the glass. We're always told a little barbaric, but if I can chip it off the glass, teeth level, chances are he ain't going to block it. And if he does, he won't do it next time. I guarantee you that. So you got to try to find a way to get it out of this zone. That's the most important thing. Other ways that you could do it is I could forget about the puck. As long as the timing's good, you're not going to get an interference call. The puck's coming along the wall. You've got to just come in here, hit the defenseman. Puck's sitting there. It's not going to do any damage here. Now, once I make that body contact, you got to have communication from your low center supporting. You got to get this puck out. But too many times you have players, young players, they're in this position. It's happening so quickly. They just take a little shot at it here, and it gets held in. The D are going to come down the wall. They're locking the wall. They're sealing the wall so no puck goes by. This is a real difficult thing to do for a young player because you're coming in, and you didn't have to take care of those things because your skill set can take advantage of that situation. You can come around, come in, slam your brakes on, boom, turn to the middle, get out of there quick. Well, National Hockey League, you can't because it's the National Hockey League. So this is something that you want to look for in camps as a fan. And as a player, it's difficult because these intangibles are what makes you stay in the NHL, crack the NHL or stay in the NHL for a long time. And it's something you got to learn by doing it. And it's very difficult for younger players to do it.
We are going to watch the 5 feet in front of the blue line and the 5 feet behind the blue line. It's not just about the goals during camp season.